Good evening. Merry Christmas to you. Okay. We're really glad that you're here with us to celebrate such a joyous event. On the behalf of our church, on our Presbyterian church, I'd like to welcome every single person in the congregation here. We thank you for coming, and we hope that you'd enjoy your presence with us in the presence of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Can we please bow our heads and close our eyes in an opening prayer? Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for gathering us here in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you because it is through him that this meeting has been made possible. We thank you because one day you decided to give us your only begotten Son to reconcile us with you, Father. We thank you for the best gift that we could have ever received. We are coming today to thank you, to show our gratitude. With grateful hearts, we are coming to praise you and worship you. Father God, we are coming to give you the glory that you deserve. Dear Lord Jesus, we are coming to celebrate your birth today for the sake of sinners like me and my brothers and sisters. We thank you because one day you came to our earth, you united with our weaknesses in our body of flesh. You lived among us. You died, and the third day you rose victorious. We thank you so much, dear Lord, for leaving us with such an example of how we are supposed to follow you. Please accept everything that we say and do for your glory today. We are declaring that this is all about you. In Jesus' name we pray, and all God's children said, amen. So, in case you haven't noticed, how many people have been shopping in the past week? Just you? Wow. How many people started shopping about a month ago? Okay, yeah. How many people started 2 weeks ago? All right, anybody went shopping today? All right, that took courage. Let's give them a hand. That took courage. Good job. If you found parking, congratulations. But of those of you who have been to malls, you've definitely seen that we're living in a society that is choosing to deny the celebration that we're having tonight. Christmas is becoming a holiday and not a Christian event, not a Christian celebration. But this is why we're gathered tonight, to declare in the heavens that we are still firm believers that Christ was born on our earth for our sake. This is the day where we celebrate, no matter how much the world tries to change things around us. I'd like you to think through this ceremony with a mindset that this is all about Christmas, the birth of Christ. Please enjoy everything that we say and do, but I'm going to ask you, as we sing our first two songs, please stand with us and sing with us the first two songs. They're congregational songs, so please stand up and join us in singing.
Sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs implode. Now fields and floods, rock hills and plains, repeat the sounding joy. Repeat the sounding joy. Repeat, repeat the sounding joy. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove with glories of his righteousness. wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his love.
Luke 1:26. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end."
"How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age. And she, who was said to be unable to conceive, is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her.
am frightened by the load I bear. In a world as cold as stone, must I walk this path alone? Be with me now. Be with me now. Breath of heaven, hold me together. Be forever near me. Breath of heaven. Breath of heaven, lighten my dark. As you watch my face, if a wiser one should have had my place, but I offer all I am for the mercy of your plan.
Breath of heaven, breath of heaven.
Matthew 1:18. This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law, and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from his sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet: "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel," which means God with us.
long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible said. Mary's boy child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day. Long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible said. Mary's boy child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day. Hark now, hear the angels sing, a king was born today. And now we'll live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
While shepherds watch their flocks by night, they see a bright new shining star. They hear a choir sing a song, the music seemed to come from afar.
Hark now, hear the angels sing, a king was born today. And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
Stable all forlorn, and in a manger, cold and dark, Mary's little boy was born.
Hark now, hear the angels sing, a king was born today, and man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. A king was born today, and man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. Hark now, hear the angels sing, a king was born today, and man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had said. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Christ at the door. Christ the everlasting Lord. Made in time, behold him come.
All sweet love, a treacherous one.
Veiled in flesh, the Godhead seen. Right now we're going to have a chance to watch a short film called More Than Gifts. This film was a compiled effort of the youth group as a whole. They've all worked on this together. You might be playing a bit too soon. That's okay. So everything that is done in this film is prepared solely by the youth of Cornerstone. Please enjoy.
Pete, check this out.
What is it, Freddy?
I've been looking for a Christmas present for my sister for so long, and I think I finally found it.
Really? What is it?
Well, I'm gonna get her this stuffed doll.
Nice. I think she's gonna like it. So what are you getting for Christmas?
Well, I'm really hoping to get a new video game, you know, for my Xbox.
Yeah.
So what are you getting?
I don't think I'm getting anything for Christmas. Like, as you know, my parents don't believe in Christmas.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Well, since you're not doing anything on Christmas Eve, do you want to come over to my house and maybe we can hang out?
Okay, sure. I'll check my parents and see.
All right. Well, it's getting kind of late, so we should probably go home.
Yeah, sure.
Honey, when's Pete supposed to be home? It's getting late and I'm getting worried about him.
I said he's with Freddy. He should be here very soon.
All right.
See? That's him right now.
You're always right.
Hey, Mom.
Hey.
Hey, Dad.
Hey, son. How was your day?
Fine. I have a question.
What is it, Pete?
I'm wondering if I could go to Freddy's house on the Christmas Eve.
I'm not sure about that one, Pete.
Calvin, come on, let him go. It'll be fun. It won't be that bad.
Yeah, I guess, but we should probably call Freddy's parents to double check with them.
Yeah, we should.
Do you think we're ready for Christmas Eve?
I think so. I mean, there's still a few things we gotta figure out, but I think we have enough time.
Okay.
And you know who's coming this year?
Who's coming?
Uncle James.
Well, I can't wait to see him.
Yeah, I mean, we haven't seen him in a long time,
yeah.
So I'm really happy he's coming this year. And I think, I'm not sure, but maybe Grandma will read a story this year. Oh,
okay.
Give me 1 sec.
No.
Hello?
Hello, Anna. It's Calvin.
Oh, hey, Calvin.
Pete mentioned that Freddy invited Pete over for Christmas Eve.
Yeah, he did. We would love to have him.
Well, that's so nice of you guys.
Okay, 7 sounds like a good time.
Okay, we'll drop him off at 7. Take care.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye.
So I'm going?
Yes, son, you are.
Yes! Thank you, Dad. Thank you, Mom.
No problem, son.
You know, Melissa, I don't know if we should have done that.
How come?
I just don't want him exposed to their beliefs.
Yeah, but he's not going there for the beliefs. He's just going there to have fun with Freddy.
I know, but you know we don't believe in Christ or Christmas.
Yeah, but he's only 12. Just let him have some fun.
Yeah, I guess it shouldn't hurt too much.
Yeah, we're just gonna have to see how it goes.
Yeah, let's go get some rest.
Thank you.
Hey, Freddy.
Hey, Pete. Merry Christmas.
Happy holidays.
Thanks. I'm glad you came. Come in.
Thank you.
Mom, Dad, Pete's here.
Oh, hey, Pete.
Hey, Pete. Merry Christmas.
Hey, happy holidays.
Oh, son, we say Merry Christmas.
Oh, sorry. Merry Christmas.
But that's fine. We're about to have dinner, so come on in.
Thank you.
Can you believe the holiday hours?
It's so busy.
Thank you, Annie, for that amazing dinner.
No problem, dear. But I can't take all the credit. So thank you guys for helping. You guys really made it special. So, Pete, how'd you like dinner?
It was good, thanks. So what's gonna happen next?
What do you think happens next?
Open up the gifts?
Don't rush, Pete. It's not all about the gifts.
And what is it about?
Christmas is about the birth of Christ. The birth of a hope for mankind.
In fact, the story is found in God's Word, the Bible. James, can you pass me the Bible, please?
Sure.
And can you read us a story?
Sure. Gather around, everyone. And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. The census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. For behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was the angel, a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
Amen. Jesus' story does not end there. They lived the perfect life, and one day, wicked people nailed him to a cross. He shed his blood, he died, but then on the third day, he rose again. He took the punishment that all of us sinners deserve.
That's right, Dad. In Romans 3:23, as the Bible tells us, "For all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God."
You're absolutely right, James. And Jesus promised us in John 1:12, that to all who received him and believed in his name, he gave them the right to become the children of God.
If you have sinned and you want to be forgiven, just pray to God and ask him to forgive you and ask to receive the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior.
Remember, son, Christmas is more than just gifts.
Anna, can you please lead us in prayer?
Sure. Let's bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for letting every single person in this room join us today. Join us for another year, another chance to celebrate Christmas. Lord, I ask that everyone here truly understands why we celebrate Christmas. We celebrate it because you sent your son to us, to save us. You sealed our fates and let us be your children. Lord, I ask as we celebrate Christmas, we never forget that. In Jesus' name I pray.
My name
name is Irini, and I'm one of the youth leaders. So I'm standing up here to share with you a few thoughts on behalf of the youth group. I was the one who was voluntold, but gladly honored to stand up here and to share with you all. Again, I'm very proud of our youth group, and they've been working really hard and doing a great job at it. In addition to being a youth leader, I must say, you know, because I hang around them all the time, maybe bad company corrupts good character, but I'm addicted to my phone. So I actually was able to do the whole sermon on this phone right here. And I was actually trying to do a fancy PowerPoint, but it didn't go through, so that's fine. We're just going to stick with the sermon for now. As you saw how this skit was about more than gifts, there was a song that my husband actually shared with me, and I wanted to say the lyrics to you all, and it's about, what is Christmas? Do you find it hard to sleep till night, resting by the Christmas lights? Could there be something you forgot beyond the bows and mistletoes? The tree with presents wrapped below, there's more to this than you had ever thought. Have we lost the reason that we celebrate each year? And the chorus goes, what is Christmas if there never was a savior wrapped in a manger? What is Christmas without Christ? Remember how the story goes. God's gift was wrapped in swaddling clothes. Beneath the star one great and holy night, the shepherds heard the angels sing. The wise men brought an offering. Peace on earth began in Bethlehem. Have we lost a reason that we celebrate each year? This is Christmas. It's all about the Savior wrapped in a manger. This is Christmas because of Jesus Christ. This is Christmas because of Christ, because of Christ. So I'm going to start first by sharing what is not Christmas. I'm sure you all are thinking in your mind, what is not Christmas? Christmas is not about shopping. Christmas is not about gifts. Christmas is not about new clothes. Christmas is not about lights and trees. Christmas is not about Santa Claus. Yes, kids, I'm sorry, it's not about Santa Claus. And Christmas is not about just family dinners. These are all good things, and they're all great to have. But they were a way, an expression to celebrate Christmas. It's not what Christmas is about. We know that Christmas is about Jesus Christ, but there were three things that I wanted to focus on tonight to make you reflect on what Christmas is about. Personally, when I think of Christmas, I think of joy. I think of miracles and hope, and I think of sharing the good news. It's the best time that we should be experiencing that. And unfortunately, in this world and in this time, it's the least joyous time. It's the least time where people are hopeful, and no one is focused or even wanting to concentrate on sharing the good news. Everyone is busy with other things. So let's reflect a little bit on how is it joy. I'm going to read Matthew chapter 2, verses 10 and 11. When they saw the star, they were filled with joy. They entered the house and saw the child with his mother, Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasure chests and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. These were the wise men. The wise men were searching to find out, where will this king be born? And they went out and about their way to search for the Savior. And then when they found him, their hearts were filled with joy, the Bible said. And we should also have our hearts filled with joy by that remembrance, even if circumstances are hard. But just to remember that Jesus Christ came to this earth humble as a baby boy, born in a manger for you and for me. That should be joyous enough. And in 2 Corinthians 5:17, the Bible says, this means that anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone, a new life has begun. Isn't that enough to make you joyous? And I know that circumstances are really hard. Trust me, I have two kids right now, and it's been quite an adventure. But it's every time I just close my eyes and reflect on the reason for the season, which is Jesus Christ, that should be joyous enough. And the second point of miracles and hope, when I reflect upon this time of Jesus' birth, there were a lot of miracles that happened around this time. And I'm going to share again from Luke chapter 1, verses 34 to 37. Mary asked the angel, "But how can this happen? I'm a virgin." Miracle number one. The angel replied, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the baby to be born will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God. What's more, your relative Elizabeth has become pregnant in her old age." Technically, that's miracle number one, and then she became pregnant afterwards. So people used to say she was barren, but she has conceived a son and is now in her 6th month, for nothing is impossible with God. The fact that Elizabeth was barren and God gave her a child, that's a miracle. The fact that Mary's a virgin and she was conceived with a child, that's a miracle. There are a lot of miracles that we can reflect on and have that hope and believe and trust that God is faithful to do and complete all that he promised us with. Even when times are rough and we don't get what we want now, and even when we feel hurt in Luke 1:25, actually, Elizabeth was saying, "How kind the Lord is," she explained. "He has taken away my disgrace of having no children." God is faithful to take away our disgrace, whatever it is, whether it's our job or our school or family or relationships. God is faithful to take away that disgrace. And when we reflect upon this time, to remember the miracle and the hope of Christmas. Mark 10:45 says, "For even the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve others and to give his life as a ransom for many." Again, that's hope right there. The miracle and hope, the miracle of Jesus' birth and the hope that we know he will take away our disgrace and that he's come to give up his life for us. And the last point is sharing the good news. If I share from Hebrews 2, verse 14. It says, "Because God's children are human beings made of flesh and blood, the Son also became flesh and blood. For only as a human being could he die, and only by dying could he break the power of the devil who had the power of death." That was the only way of our salvation, that Jesus would be born as human and to be able to go to that path of the cross. That was our only way of being able to be given that second chance and to enjoy that eternal life. Every time I get consumed in wanting to buy these pretty clothes or get all this fancy gifts or whatever, and I realize that really my treasures are not here, my treasure is in heaven, and that it's Jesus who came to this world that made that possible. An example of people who shared the good news is from Luke 2, verses 15 to 18. "When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, 'Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about.' They hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph. And there was the baby lying in the manger. After seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child. All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished. The shepherds went back to their flocks, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was just as the angel had told them." The shepherds, simple people, yet they did the right thing. After they saw Jesus Christ, they could not stop, but they went out and about to share and what they saw and to proclaim the beauty of that moment. This is what Christmas is about. There is joy, believe it or not, seek it and you will find this joy. It should remind us of miracles and hope, even when it's hopeless and when you find that you're kind of stuck, remember this moment and trust in the Lord. And it is a time to share the good news, just like our dear Pete here who learned about Jesus Christ and the good news. It is an opportunity for us. When people tell us happy holidays, it could be a chance to say, well, it's actually Merry Christmas to me, but thank you. And when anyone is wondering what, you know, the Christmas is about, this would be the chance where you can share what you believe your faith is. It is a great opportunity. And last but not least, I will conclude with a foreword one of the youth shared with me. Christmas. I wish I had this actually up on PowerPoint, but picture it. Christmas, C-H-R-I-S-T-M-A-S, and C represents Christ gave H himself as reward so that individuals know the sacrifices that he made for mankind to achieve the gift of salvation. Amen. Okay, let's bow our heads in prayer. Father God, I want to thank you, Lord, for this amazing night of remembering and reflecting and celebrating the birth of your Son, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for knowing that that's the only way that you'd be able to bring us to you, dear God, that we'd be able to be in that relationship with you and experience that love, Lord, that nothing can separate us from. You deserve all the power, all the honor, all the glory, dear God. And we thank you, for you are so good. We ask you, Lord, that this time would be a pleasing time to you as we are presenting all our songs and our acting and our talents, that it would be a nice gift to you. Happy birthday, Jesus. Amen. May I please ask Reverend Sharif Garz to come up and lead us into the next step of the ceremony.
أنا بس نفسي أقول إيه اللي إحنا بنعمله في الكاندل لايت سيرفيس.
I would just like to share what it is that we're doing about the candlelight service.
إحنا بنبقى عايزين بالعمل الرمزي اللي إحنا بنعمله ده عايزين نقول إن المسيح هو نور العالم.
With this symbolic tradition, we just want to proclaim that Christ is the light of the world.
المسيح جه عشان يعلن لينا عن مين هو الله.
Christ came to proclaim to us who God really is.
فالمسيح أضاء في ظلمة قلوبنا.
Christ lit in the darkness of our hearts.
عشان كده احنا بنيجي في ليلة زي دي بنعمل عمل رمزي، احنا بنولع شمعة صغيرة.
That's why we come tonight to do a symbolic tradition of lighting a small candle.
بنبقى عايزين نقول المسيح جه للعالم وفي نفس الوقت جه أضاء في ظلمة قلوبنا.
We want to say that Jesus came to this world and at the same time he lit the darkness of our hearts.
ولما بنولع الشمع لبعض,
and when we are lighting the candles of others,
بيبقى الفكرة انه نور المسيح, حياة المسيح, الخلاص ربنا عايزك تنشره لكل العالم.
The idea is that the light of Christ, the salvation, is the way of spreading it to all the world.
يسوع قال انا نور العالم.
Jesus said, I am the light of the world.
ولما غير حياتنا قال انتم نور العالم.
And when he changed our lives, he said, you are the light of the world.
فالعمل اللي احنا بنقوم بيه النهاردة عمل رمزي علشان يذكركم.
So whatever we're doing today is a symbolic thing to remind you.
انه حياة المسيح انت مفروض تنقلها للعالم اللي انت عايش فيه.
That the life of Jesus Christ, you're supposed to spread it to the world that you're living in.
حينما نضيء هذه الشمعة احنا بنقول الشمعة دي ترمز للمسيح.
When we light this candle, we're saying that this candle represents Jesus.
انا هطلب من الأشر ان هم يوزعوا عليكم الشمعة.
I'm going to ask the ushers to come up and to hand out the candles.
بالنسبة للساندي سكول احنا
نديهم حاجة صغيرة. We're gonna give them an alternative.
And now I want you just to listen carefully to me. The Lord Jesus in John chapter 8, he said, I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in the darkness, but will have the light of life. أنا هو نور العالم من يتبعني فلا يمشي في الظلمة بل يكون له نور الحياة. When Jesus speaks of himself as the light, this picture salvation as the entrance of light in the dark hearts of sinners. Darkness speaks of death, ignorance, sin. Darkness speaks also of separation from God. As I said before, when Jesus said, when he speaks of himself as the light, this picture salvation, the word salvation means deliverance from sin and its consequences, remission of sins, freedom from the yoke of enemy, from Satan. Sin causes death, spiritual death, separation from God. Jesus Christ is Savior because he brings God and man together in the fellowship of love. Jesus said, I am the light. Jesus speaks of himself as the light of redemption, in contrast to the darkness of condemnation, the eternal life in contrast of eternal death, eternal separation from God, heaven in contrast to hell. Therefore, before lighting your candle, let me ask each one of us, is Jesus the light of your heart? Listen carefully and think about my question tonight. Is really Jesus the light of your heart? We call this candle the light of Christ. It is an object, element, a symbol we do use in our worship in the church, just to represent Christ in our midst, or just to remind ourselves with the Lord Jesus Christ is the light of our lives. The candlelight service is the time for lighting candles, just an act to say to one another that Jesus is my light. Jesus is my salvation. In the other hand, when you light your candle, you tell Jesus, I promise to be a light among my family. I promise, when you light your candle, you tell Jesus, I promise to be a light among my friends in the school, in the college. I promise to be a light in my work. I promise to be a light. Spread the light. Spread the light. Jesus is the light of our lives. Go spread the light. Go tell the people about the Lord Jesus and about the salvation He brings to our life.
Jesus Christ is born.
shepherds feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out the angel chorus that hailed the Savior's birth.
Oh, heaven on the mountains, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountains that Jesus Christ is born.
Down in a lowly manger, the humble Christ was born. And God sent us salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountains, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountains that Jesus.
One more time, go tell it on the mountains.
Go tell it on the mountains, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountains that Jesus Christ is born. That Jesus Christ is born. That Jesus Christ is born.
Hallelujah.
Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Prospero Año y Felicidad. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Prospero Año y Felicidad.
كل سنة وانتم طيبين.
في كل عيد ميلاد.
في كل عيد ميلاد.
بنحب نقول لكم كل سنة وانتم طيبين. بتمنى ليكم يوم سعيد. بتمنى ليكم يوم سعيد. بتمنى ليكم خير كتير. أكتر كتير من كل اللي فات. بتمنى ليكم يوم سعيد. بتمنى ليكم يوم سعيد. بتمنى ليكم خير كتير. أكتر كتير من كل اللي فات. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad.
Gris.
Feliz Navidad.
Gris.
Prospero año y felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart.
Christmas.
The grace of our Lord Jesus, the love of the Father and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you. Amen.